Welcome to Studio D on the campus of the University of Oklahoma. This is Sooner Sports Pad. And now, here's your host, Madeline Roberts.
Hello and welcome to Sooner Sports Pad. I'm your host, Russell Westbrook. Madeline Roberts, and I'm here with my co-analyst, Reagan Ledbetter, who just got drafted by the Pittsburgh Penguins, and Carson Williams, who is a professional golfer.
That's right.
We also have a very loud live studio audience with us this evening.
Hey, we've got a bunch of rowdy OU students in the crowd tonight on Halloween Eve. Let's get rowdy.
And we have two very special guests, Khadeem Lattin and Jordan Shepherd, OU basketball stars, here in the audience.
Later on in Face-Off, Reagan and I will talk about who our MVPs were from Saturday's big win over Texas Tech.
And we later will take a look at an annual Halloween crowd favorite here on campus that raises money for a good cause.
Well, the Sooners moved to 7-1 on the season on Saturday with a dominating 49-27 win over quarterback Baker Mayfield's previous team, the Texas Tech Red Raiders. The two teams got off to blazing hot starts, trading touchdowns in the first quarter. Both CeeDee Lamb and Dimitri Flowers scored touchdowns, while the Red Raiders had three of their own to make the score 20-14 Tech after the first. However, the Sooners defense turned it around after that, allowing Texas Tech just one more touchdown, which came in the third quarter on a 9-yard touchdown pass from Nick Szymanek to Cameron Batson. However, the Sooners offense stayed hot, as five different Sooners had a touchdown in the second half to win 49-27. Reagan, the Sooners offense hung almost half a hundred on the Texas Tech defense. What did you see from the offense in this game?
Well, Carson and I were talking about this after the game. This might have been the most complete game the Sooners offense has had all year long. New guys continuing to step up. Tech got out to that early lead, but the Sooners answered right back with that touchdown strike to CeeDee Lamb over the middle of the field. It was back and forth touchdowns the whole first quarter, but Rodney Anderson really stepped up and had another huge day on the ground. Very physical running, ran all over that Tech defense, and a big touchdown in the second quarter. Then the big man, Mark Andrews, continued his hot year with another touchdown to help the Sooners pull away. Big day for Rodney, though, 181 yards. Huge day, 336 for the whole team, 281 passing yards. They topped 600 yards for the sixth game this season. Putting up big numbers in a Lincoln Riley offense. Gotta love it.
That's impressive. On the other side of the ball, the defense, it was kind of another slow start, but that did not last long. I'll tell you what. After the first quarter, OU really turned it around. Mike Stoops made an adjustment and went with that four-man front, and that paid off big. OU gave up 20 points and 211 yards in the first quarter, but they allowed just 7 points and 226 yards the rest of the game. A big turnaround for OU. Maybe OU's best defensive performance of the year. Caleb Kelly got his first interception. Stephen Parker and Parnell Motley both could have had one as well. DJ Ward had a good game. Everybody played well, I thought. I was really impressed with the Sooner defense after that first quarter. The kind of play that they need going forward if they want to get back to the college football playoff.
Good start playing that Tech offense with the ball a lot.
Because this week they play OSU, another high-powered offense, going to be good.
Oklahoma State can score a lot of points
very quickly.
They can
score more than Tech, so OU's defense is going to have to be on point on Saturday.
Good three quarters of football for
That's
them.
That's right. Stephen Parker did have a big game for the Sooners, and earlier today, SportsPad's Kenneth Adair caught up with Parker to talk about Saturday's performance.
I felt like we responded, you know, very well. Offensively, we came out strong. Defensively, we didn't come out strong, you know. But I felt like, you know, as both sides kind of adjust a little bit, we started to complement each other, I felt like, a lot more this game than other games.
And after the first quarter, after the first half, y'all guys were able to make a lot of adjustments. What were some of those adjustments after halftime?
Just getting our run fits and making sure that our pass defense is a lot better. We added a couple of guys that we could step back in the zone or, go ahead and man up, and I felt like we started to do that.
And you're an Oklahoma kid. This is your final Bedlam game. Just talk about what this game means to you.
This game means a lot to me. I mean, it goes so deep to where it's, me and my parents in the house. My parents used to have Oklahoma State stocking, and I used to have an Oklahoma stocking. So, I mean, it goes really deep, just in my own little family ties. But, it goes even deeper than that.
And Oklahoma State, the Cowboys have one of the most prolific offenses in the country. What are some of the things you're doing, focus on this week, to make sure you can handle them Saturday?
Preparation. Preparation is the key. As long as I'm watching film or we're all watching film, making sure that we're going hard in practice, that's going to be the great start right there.
All right. Thank you, Steven.
Thank you so much.
Well, today I'm dressed up as Thunder basketball star Russell Westbrook. So, Carson, I hear the OU men's basketball team is in action. Let's talk about that a little
bit. That's true. A lot of basketball happening on this set. OU men's hoops had a scrimmage on Saturday against UT Arlington to help raise money for the United Way's Harvey Recovery Fund. UTA did edge OU 99-84, but it was just a scrimmage, and it was also for a good cause. One good takeaway, though, I thought, was junior Christian James. He led the way with 28 points off the bench, has had a tremendous offseason, and will be a key contributor for Long Cougar this season. Him, Khadeem, Jordan, big-time players. Let's not forget Trey Young coming in. Cam Gusty. They're going to be good, and we're going to touch on more on that later, but
we will. That was just a tease.
Yeah, exactly. But a good cause on Saturday for the men's squad.
Well, the Sooners women's soccer team ended their season on Friday night, regular season, unfortunately with a loss in Lubbock. But hey, there is good news because they did clinch a spot last Sunday against Kansas State with their home win and their home finale. So they will head to Kansas City later in the week for the Big 12 tournament, November 1st, 3rd, and 5th. So, the season is still alive.
Yeah, it is.
Good luck to them in that tournament. Well, it is time to take a break, but when we come back, we'll have Face Off. Stay with us. Welcome back to Sooner Sports Crowd. It is now time for Carson and Reagan to face off. Guys, as always, who were your MVPs for the week?
All right, well, Rodney Anderson had another big game. But I'm going to have to go with the kid, and that is true freshman CeeDee Lamb, who had a huge day for the Sooners. After getting hurt a few weeks back, he really hasn't been in the action much, but Saturday he came back and made up for that and had a huge day. 147 yards through the air, and that big touchdown at the start of the game was huge for the team. And then he added another touchdown near the end of the game on that nasty hit, was able to hang on, a big play for him. I think he's really a guy who Baker trusts through the air, and he's excited to have him back healthy again. 9 receptions, 147 yards, like I said, and those two big scores, all freshman single game records. Big thing for this team.
I'll tell you what, I wasn't doing that as a freshman, so
seriously,
that's pretty impressive.
Yeah, I wasn't doing
I'm
going to
go
freshman.
the guy who throws him the ball, Baker Mayfield. Let me start out by saying Baker is now 3-0 against his former team. He's 3-0 against his former team on Saturday. Another typical game for him. He continues to be the driving force, not only for this offense, I think, but Reagan, for the entire team. He's now thrown a touchdown pass in 34 consecutive games. Each game he's played in an Oklahoma uniform. And his play just goes so underappreciated, I think, as Lincoln Riley pointed out last week, because of how good and consistent he's been. Again, Saturday, 281 through the air, 4 touchdown passes, the 34th straight game with a passing touchdown, 301 total yards, got it done on the ground with his feet like he's been known to do this season. Another great game for Baker Mayfield, and the way that things have been playing out, as you know, last week, he's creeping up in the Heisman rankings, has a chance to get back to New York.
I don't know another player who means as much to their team as Baker does. It's truly impressive what he's able to do on the field.
Baker Mayfield, MVP, dilly dilly.
Heisman favorite.
Dilly dilly.
Hashtag Baker for Heisman. Well, I'm here with Faith, and she has an audience question for the two of you. Who do you think is going to score more points this year, the women's basketball team or the men's?
Ooh. All right. Well, I love Sherry Cole, but I'm going to have to go with the men on this one. I am honestly still – I'm still shocked that they're sixth in the Big 12 preseason polls. This team was very, very young last year. It was not the season they wanted, you know, record-wise, but there were a lot of close games in Big 12 play, and that's something they should be encouraged about. I think guys like Cam Gusty and Jordan Shepherd are going to have big years. And then you add, yes, the hometown kid Trey Young to the mix. How can you not be excited about that? It's going to be big for this team. You add that youth to – veterans like Khadeem Lattin and Jermoney McNeese. This team's going to surprise a lot of people this year.
I think so. Last year they finished 11-20. Could have easily finished 20-11.
There were so many games in Big 12 play that anything could have happened.
Exactly. I think that they will turn it around this year. But I'm going to have to go with the women. You know, they're ranked number 21 in the USA Today preseason coaches poll. So right off the bat, there's talent on the roster. They also returned 3 starters from last year's team that went 23-10 and made it to the second round of the NCAA tournament. There are other powerhouses in the Big 12 like Baylor and Texas, but the Sooners have a ton of talent back, and they're led by Maddie Manning. She's back again. Things are certainly looking up for Sherry Cole. They've got a shot to be really good.
That's fair. That's
I know. Yeah, I don't make unfair points.
Yeah, you're good.
Thanks. Yeah.
Okay, you guys, show me your viral videos.
All right, well, I'm wearing a hockey jersey, so why not have a hockey viral video.
Good point.
I think we have all had this moment as a young fan, you know, waiting at the tunnel for an autograph or for a glove or for a bat. Well, this kid just wanted a dang hockey stick.
You've got one. Why don't you give him one?
Look at this. Nope, he wants a stick, not a high five. Nope, not gonna take that.
Well,
nope.
I want
a stick.
A high five.
Yes, he wants a stick. Come on, bro, I want
stick.
A stick.
See, you got a stick.
Oh, he got a stick. Oh. You just made his day. Look at that. I have one too, buddy.
Nice.
There we go.
That's good. Well, okay, wait, where did you get that one?
I got this from our very awesome teacher, Barry Orr.
Nice. All right. Not from
the guy who runs all of this
exactly.
stuff.
Exactly. Anyway, so we do have basketball represented on the show. Madeline's dressed up as Russell Westbrook, but what we don't have is a baseball player. So I'm going to combine those two, basketball, baseball. You don't know
That's
what I'm
fair.
Talking about, but you're about to find out. Check it out.
Okay.
Little kid setting up a little basketball right here. Takes a big swing, and he makes it from deep. Look, he's so excited about it. Look, with the wiffle bat. Look at him go. He's so excited. Again, look at that. That's good stuff right there. It's good stuff right there.
That's gonna be my kid.
There. Two sports star coming to you here in about 12 years.
If the NBA lets him use a bat, he's gonna be pretty dang good.
Hey, that's probably 15, 20 years down the road. You never know.
And it can happen.
Well, it's now time to vote for the winner of Face Off. Cheer the loudest for who you think won.
I think
who thinks it was Reagan.
Woo!
You chose it. You put a kid in your video. Reagan. You're gonna win.
How about Carson?
Fair enough.
All right. So who won?
I think we have a clear winner here, Carson.
Wait, so I won that one.
You did win.
Okay.
Congratulations. Yes. Well, it is now time for another break. But when we come back, we'll see what the OU baseball team is doing to make a difference.
Special thanks to our cornerstone television partners, Chesapeake Energy, Riverwind Resort, Anheuser-Busch, OU Outreach, and OU Medicine.
Welcome back to Sooner Sports Pad. Every year around Halloween, the OU baseball team hosts its annual Halloween game to raise money for charity. And as Sports Pad's Zach Brown shows us, this year the team knocked it out of the park.
OU softball and baseball teamed up for the annual Halloween game last week. The game saw players from both teams dressed up and raising money for various fundraising campaigns, including the Children's Hospital in Norman. Although a fun event to watch, moments like these have big effects on the lives of so many, including those playing in the game.
I think it's an awesome event. Everything was well put together, and this really hits home for me, and it affects my family personally, so I think this is just a great cause overall.
While out in the field having a blast, players certainly knew that this event meant much more than just playing another game.
It means a lot to me. You know, softball and baseball get together for a great cause, and it means a lot that we can help out in any way that we can.
It means a lot, you know, against the softball team, you know, softball versus baseball. There's a lot of stuff that goes there, and, you know, it's for a great cause, and it's a lot of fun for the kids, you know, get to see us in the costumes, so it was a good time.
Children and players in attendance were all dressed up for the fun-filled action on the field, so picking the right costume had a lot of pressure. Each had their own inspirations for how they dressed.
I was actually at the Halloween store, and I saw this, and I saw the teddy bear when I went to Walmart, and I figured it'd be a good match for just to come out here for the kids, you know.
Honestly, my great buddy Kate Harris was the squirrel the last 2 years. He went a different direction, and I felt like I had to keep it in the family, keep the tradition going of the squirrel, you know. Everybody loved it the last 2 years, had to keep it going.
We just wanted to be something funny. I mean,
yeah, it wasn't really like anything like really that we planned. We're just like, oh, let's just be football players.
So. Yeah, and we went all out with it, so.
Had everything.
Got the
sleeves.
Taped our cleats and everything.
To put an end to what was a brilliant night at the Marita Hines Field, a home run derby was held in which money was raised for each bomb hit. The money raised was just as important as the attention drawn to a cause that affects the lives of so many.
I think it's just awesome seeing how people are recognizing this and actually coming out and watching and contributing and donating and just showing more awareness for this.
The Family Fun Halloween Baseball event raised more than $15,000 today, with $2,450 coming from the game alone. Proceeds benefit the Children's Hospital at the OU Medical Center. Zach Brown, Sooner Sports Pad.
Now let's hear here from OU Basketball's Jordan Shepherd and Khadeem Lattin.
The stars. Thanks for coming, guys.
Thanks for being here. So, first question, last year you guys finished 11-20, probably not what you guys wanted. What do you have to do, or what have you done this offseason to get back to where you were 2 years ago?
We've done a lot. We also had a trip to Australia where we got 10 extra practices, so we did a lot there. Everybody's been in the gym, especially Christian, James, Trey, Khadeem, myself, Ty. So that's what we've been doing.
Great answer.
So you mentioned that trip, you know, to New Zealand. Khadeem, how was that, you know, for you guys as a whole?
Man, it was cool. We got to experience some things that we would never experience otherwise. I mean, we just, our bond as brothers became more and we became closer. We got to really learn about each other, and it was fun. I mean, plus, like, we beat everybody by, like, 30, 40. Yeah, so, I mean, it was fun. Like,
it was good. You guys had a very young team last year, a lot of freshmen and a lot of playing time. Is it encouraging, though, to, you know, have so many close games in Big 12 play with so much, you know, inexperience?
Definitely. I mean, last year you saw, like, I think more than majority of our games we lost by a five point or less margin. And, I mean, we just learned through fire last year. We figured out what we needed to do this year and how we do it. So, I mean, we're ready. I mean, my young guys are ready. They're experienced now. So, yeah. We're hitting the floor running. Yeah.
This year in the Big 12, where do you guys, what are your expectations, I guess? Where would you grade yourself as far as in conference?
For one, I think that's too low. Yeah. I think it's disrespectful to us. But
where do you think it should be?
Top four. Top three, top four.
Yeah, I like it. Well, there's a lot of hype around Trae Young coming here, obviously, but, you know, with a five-star athlete like that having to come in here, that can kind of, you know, do negative things for a team, but it really has kind of brought you guys together. Does that just show how close you guys are a team heading into this year?
Yeah, I mean, last year, I mean, and since I've been here, we've it's been nothing but a family-type environment and locker room. So with that being said, like, Trae coming in here, I mean, he's adjusted well, man. He's been acclimated. I mean, he's a guru on the court. He knows what he's doing. So with that being said, it's just getting him fully acclimated in, and he's doing a great job every day. So I'm excited to see where he's gonna help us get.
All right, Trae!
Does he still do things that kind of amaze you guys?
Yeah, I have to guard him every day. So yeah.
Yeah. I bet that's fun.
Nah, it's competitive.
Yeah, it's definitely.
You know, his shot is crazy, but one thing that's underrated about him is his passing ability. Hmm. You know, he's a great point guard when he's out there.
Khadeem, you're the one senior on this team. So what have you learned throughout your, you know, 3 years at OU that you've kind of instilled in these younger guys?
Just, you know, fight, family, stay together. The road is going to get tough. I mean, and if we stick together, man, we can get through the road, period. So, I mean, just figuring it out. We fight together. I mean, we fight for each other. So.
Thank you. That's the audience question.
That's right. Faith has a question for you guys.
What's it like being so tall?
Good man. Straight up.
You can't buy clothes. You can't buy shoes. Nah, it's cool. I mean, like, whenever you see someone cute, you feel me, it's an icebreaker just to tell them, like, you feel me, how tall are you? I'm 6'9". You feel me, we can talk. It works.
Using it to his advantage, yeah, I like it.
We're
going
to take another break, but when we come back, we'll have dynamic duos. Stay with us. Duos. Before the show, I asked Khadeem a series of questions about himself, and now Jordan will attempt to answer them correctly. And during the break, just now, Jordan guaranteed he would get all these questions right. So I'm excited to see if it happens.
Put me on the spot.
All right, question number one. Who's Kadeem's favorite NBA player? Is it A, Kevin Garnett, B, Kyrie Irving, C, James Harden, or D, me, Russell Westbrook?
I'm going to go with Kevin Garnett, but that James Harden one seems tempting considering he's from Houston.
Garnett. You got it right. Okay. Khadeem, I'm going to be honest. I'm a little hurt, but that's okay. We'll move on. Question number two. When Khadeem was a kid, what did he want to be when he grew up? Is it A, a teacher, B, an astronaut, C, a chef, Or D, a marine biologist?
Marine biologist! Yeah. Yeah.
So my guy's going with marine biologist.
I like it. Wow. The audience knows.
Talking about it.
All right, two for two. Let's see if you can get number three right. What is Khadeem's favorite Halloween movie? Is it A, Saw? B, Hocus Pocus?
Okay.
C, Halloween Town? Or D, Texas Chainsaw Massacre?
Halloween Town.
C, Halloween Town.
Three.
All right, question number four. If Khadeem could dunk on one current NBA player, who would he dunk on? Is it A, LeBron James, B, Dwight Howard, C, Steph Curry, or D, Lonzo Ball?
Lonzo! Lonzo!
Dwight Howard.
Going with B, Dwight. Let's see. Wow. All right, last question. Let's see if you can go five for five. What is Khadeem's least favorite Halloween candy? Is it A, candy corn, B, Almond Joy, C, Dots, or D, M&Ms?
We both hate this candy a lot. Candy corn.
A, candy corn. Let's see. Candy corn! Five for five. You really deliver. Thank you for tuning in to this spooky edition of Sooner Sports Fan. Be sure to like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter and Instagram, and be back here next Monday, same time, same place. Have a good Halloween, everybody.